The Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayeb, has scaled up his oversight tours to National Agricultural Research Organization, NARO, in Namulonge, Gayaza, where he inspected several innovations taking place in the agricultural sector. Tayeb was impressed with the research taking place. Professor William Mulaho Mukani, the chairman governing council of NARO, used the event to urge the government to expedite the passing of the National Biotechnology and Biosafety Bill, commonly known as the Genetically Modified Organisms Bill, to increase food productivity and safety.
We are going to increase production. If we are going to increase biosafety, even this aflasafe we are seeing protecting us from aflatoxin, we need biotechnology.
Professor Mulaho argued that the law has been frustrated by non-scientists who distort its intentions. He added that the absence of this law has seen GMOs hitting the market legally with no controls.
Has been tossed up and down. There are people who think they know science more than us, and they are confusing the whole system. But we as scientists are saying we need this bill so that we can regulate issues of biotechnology, issues of GMO.
In his response, Tayeb rejected the prayer, saying GMOs can't be accepted in Uganda due to their negative health impact. Without mincing words, he told of scientists to forget about the law and concentrate on other things.
I'm one of the people, by the way, who fought the bill, I want to confess in front of you. I'm the one who disagreed with scientists, and I'm ready to continue doing that.
He noted that scientists rejected insertion of a strict liability clause in this bill, which makes GMO makers legally liable for health defects that can happen to any person who consumes GMO foods. He emphasized that Uganda can't tolerate GMO foods, which were rejected on the European market.
We asked you, we said, okay, for us, we are historians, we don't know what, we are not qualified to challenge scientists, but we are also lawyers. Okay? So we said, let us introduce a strict liability clause so that you are strictly liable if your products cause cancer. You said no.
The deputy speaker also challenged NARO to invest in commercialization of their innovations. He was concerned that scientists have made several innovations, but these prototypes are catching dust in laboratories.
If you reduce on the research and you first go into commercialization, you alone, you can easily raise 100 billion through NTR, and that money would go back to you. And you don't have to do it yourselves. We have UDC, we have NEC. These are vehicles, special purpose vehicles of government, which can help you to commercialize.
Tayeb was flanked by the Minister of Agriculture, Frank Tumwebaze, Minister of State for Fisheries, Helen Adoa, and members of Parliament on the Committee of Agriculture. Tumwebaze emphasized the need for the government to enhance funding for scientists at NARO.
Science is science. Even those who manufacture the vaccines, in the ones we took recently, it's the same formula. It's the same system. Or what perhaps is different in the different environments is the technology, but not the brains.
NARO appealed to government to enhance their budget by 50% to 300 billion shillings in order to establish enough capacity. Currently, the entity is into partnerships with private sector players to see that products of research find their way to the market. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.